Hi everyone, I'm Cody at W3AMG with Bridgecom Systems, and today we're going to be showing you how to create a code plug for your Anytone handheld radio. This is super awesome and super exciting because this means soon we're going to be on the air. Okay, so we've got our radio here. First thing you want to do is take your programming cable, plug it into your computer, there we go, and then go ahead and plug the other side into your radio. Just open up this flap here like that, and then plug in the programming cable. After that, make sure your radio is turned on. Now we're gonna jump over here to the computer. Once you're on the computer, go ahead and open up your CPS, your programming software. Now, if you don't have this, we have a video that will show you how to download it. In this case, we already have it, so we're good to go. Now, go ahead and select the COM port button right up here in the center between the read button and the write button. So we'll select the COM port. There you go, COM3, we can see it. If there's multiple here and you're not sure which one is the radio, just unplug your radio, you'll see it drop off. Then when you plug it back in, it'll show up. There we go, go ahead and click OK. Now we can read from radio. So click the read from radio button. We won't save any changes. Click OK, and you can just read the other data. Now it is crucial that we read from the radio to the computer first. Otherwise, things can get out of sync and you'll spend a lot of time building your code plug and then you'll run into a band error. So we want to eliminate that, so make sure you read from your radio. There we go, read data complete. We are good to go now. We have some just basic channels. I like to just delete these, but it doesn't matter if you leave them. So what do we put in our radio? Well, part of that's totally up to you. I'll give you some pointers on what you can do. If you have a SkyBridge, you can set it up for that. If you don't, but you have a local repeater, you could use it for that too. All kinds of fun stuff we can do with the radio. Today, we're gonna show you how to use your local repeater. So what I'm going to do is open up a web browser and go to repeaterbook.com. There we go, repeaterbook.com. Once you're there, go ahead and select your region, in this case, North American repeaters. Repeaterbook is a big database of almost all of the repeaters out there. If you don't have access to this, you can ask your local club or people who got you into ham radio, whoever you know about if there's a local repeater, they'll probably be able to help you out with that information. But I like Repeaterbook, it's a great resource. Then go to your state. Once you're there, there's a variety of options. You can filter based on DMR or analog or, you know, whatever you want to filter with here. In this case, I'm going to choose DMR. Once you're here, there's a lot of different options. So if you know what you're searching for, you can just do a Control F at this point. You'll be able to find it. But in this case, what if we don't know what's available? Go ahead and click on Map Results. We'll click on that again. And this will actually take you to a map with all of those local repeaters in your area. So scroll down here. How cool is that? So we have our area and we can see all of those different repeaters. So if we select one that's close to us, there we go, and then just click for more. That will actually take us to the information page. Awesome, there we go. Once you're here, uplink and downlink. You'll need both of those frequencies. So what are uplink and downlink frequencies? The best way to think about it is repeaters are up high, typically on a tower. That's how I think about it. Repeaters are always up high in a tower, whereas radios, we're typically down here on the ground, right? So uplink in the eyes of the radio, which is what we're programming here today, is going to be transmit because we're transmitting up to that repeater. Downlink, on the other hand, in the eyes of the radio, is going to be received since we're receiving, you know, down from that repeater. That's the easiest way to think about it. Moving on, you want to go ahead and write those uplink and downlink frequencies down. Then you've got your color code. Go ahead and write that down. Your DMR ID. We don't really need that for this. So really just the frequencies, the color code, and then the time slot. This says use time slot 1 for all of the Brandmeister talk groups. Looks like usually there's some info in here, open talk group view, and there we go. It looks like the parrot they want on time slot 2. So make sure you record that time slot information, and we'll go ahead and use that later in the programming. But what about talk groups? We will need some talk groups if this is digital. Just to touch on this, if you're using an analog repeater, most of the information is going to be the same, but instead of color code and time slot, you may have some privacy tones. Just write those down. You'll use them basically the same way, even though they're a little bit different on the technical side. Let's go look for some talk groups. We'll just do a Google search here. I've usually had good luck with PiStar.uk and their talk group list. You can download this entire list if you'd like. Today, we're just going to search for a few. So once you get there, you can just do a Control F. And let's say I wanted Missouri. There we go. We could go ahead and add that one, write that down. What about the parrot. That way we can test it out, listen to ourselves without everyone else hearing it. Great. And there's another group you definitely want to have, which is the disconnect. There you go, Talk Group 4000. That will allow you to disconnect from a talk group and then reconnect to a different one. And why not worldwide? Go ahead and add that, Talk Group 91. There we go. We've got some talk groups written down. Great. Like I said, you could import that entire list if you'd like. Today we're just going to do a few. There we go. So we have some information. Let's go over to the software. So once we are here, we're going to go to digital and just start filling out some of the information. Radio ID list. You will have to have, for a DMR system, you will have to have a radio ID and a call sign if you're going to use this. So make sure you put in that information here. And if you don't have those, we do have some videos that will help you with that. In the name, just put your first name and call sign. Just like that. Awesome. There we go. After that, go to contact/talk group. Once you're there, we can go ahead and start adding some talk groups. So we'll double click on one. And the name is going to be obviously the name of the talk group. Let's say the parrot, for example. Add the parrot. Now it's actually a private call. Pretty much all the talk groups you're going to add are going to be group calls since they're a group of people. Now in this case, the parrot, that's a private call because we only want it to talk back to us, not everyone else. There we go, private. And then this TG/DMR ID, that's where you put the talk group number. So in this case, 9990. Click OK. Let's go ahead and add a few more. Have Missouri. Note that this one's going to be a group call, as will most of your talk groups. There we go. Awesome. So once we have our talk groups added, we should be in good shape. So go back up here to channel. And at this point, we can actually create some channels. So you can delete what's here. In this case, to save time, we're just going to skip down here. We'll click on one and go ahead and give it a name. Now, in the case of a digital repeater, if you plan to primarily use this repeater or hotspot or whatever you're programming as your primary source, what I would recommend doing is just make a channel for each of your talk groups. This way you can rotate through them. Now, if you're adding a repeater that you'll probably never use again, you can just make one channel and then select the talk group from your radio. So it just depends, but most of the time, you'll want to do what we're doing here. So go ahead and give it a name. In this case, we are going to name it Parrot. There we go. And what about the frequency? So we need to remember our uplink and downlink frequencies. So we've got those written down. So receive, that's downlink, is 444.4625. Transmit was uplink, so 449.4625. There we go. Digital. I'm going to change this to turbo power. This repeater is a little bit hard to hit from the studio, so we'll see if we can hit it or not. Make sure down here this DMR mode, if you have APRS in disabled, which it will be by standard, you may not see all this information, but DMR mode you are going to see. Make sure that is set to repeater if you're using this with a repeater. After that, here go over to the right hand side, and where it says contact, go ahead and click on that. This is where we select our talk group. So we want to choose Parrot. There you go. Color code, we wrote down that was color code 4. And time slot. Now, I think everything was time slot 1 for the most part, except for the Parrot. So we're going to change this over to time slot 2. We're good to go. That's everything you need there. Click OK. Now, here's a tip. Go ahead and just copy this. You can right click on it and copy. And then just go down here. And then from there, you can just do a Control V. And paste that. So we can just create another one real quick. All the information stays the same. We can just give it a different name. So Missouri, go ahead and change that talk group over to Missouri. Now we will change this back to time slot 1. There you go. Click OK. And we're good. Now there shouldn't be any more time slot changes. So we can copy this and we can actually just create a few of them. Just go ahead, Control V again. We can add a couple more. Same thing, we could choose worldwide. There you go. Click OK. Go down one. What else do we have left? Disconnect. We'll choose disconnect. Just like that. Click OK. and you're all set there. Awesome, so we have our channels. Now we need to actually put these into a zone or else you'll never actually see them on the radio. So go over here to the left-hand side and choose zone. We are going to create a new zone right here. We'll just name this local. Here we go. You can see all the different channels. So just go ahead and add the channels that you would like. In this case, the ones we just created. Now you have some options to select the primary channels up here. Choose them as you wish. Here we go. Click OK. And at this point, we could write this to the radio. We're in good shape here, but I want to show you a couple more things first. You definitely want to add the digital contact list to your radio if you're going to be using it a lot. So down here, the digital contact list, there's nothing in it right now. What this will do is when you're talking to someone, it will actually show their name and call sign on the screen and tell you who you're talking to. Now, this is a really neat feature, but we actually need that digital contact list first. So let's go get it. Open up a web browser and we are going to go to radioid.net. Once you're there, just go ahead and click on database and data dumps. Some great folks over at radioid.net. If you need help getting set up with your radio ID, this is the place to go. They actually issue all of the radio IDs. So we're actually getting this information from the source. Awesome, here we go. So scroll down. What you want is the user CSV. Just click on it, and this will get us the most up-to-date version. Save that somewhere. I like to put a date on mine so I know what it is and how old it is. Go ahead and save that. Open up your software again, and in this case, we're gonna go to Tool, and then go to Import, click OK. And from here, we can see Digital Contact List. So go ahead and click on that, and find the file we just downloaded. Make sure you save it somewhere you can find. There we go. Go ahead and open that up, and then just click Import. There we go, import complete. So we're good to go there. Now, all you need to do is just make sure your radio is still connected, which it is, and write to the radio, and we're gonna be all set. Before we do that, there's a couple more things I wanna do just to make your radio experience even better. So open up the optional settings, and you want to go to work mode. This is almost essential. Change over the display mode from frequency to channel. If you don't do that, you won't see any of your names and you'll be very confused. So make sure you do that. I personally like to turn the subchannel mode off. That's a personal preference. It'll just, instead of showing one display, it'll have two. You can choose to have that or not. Real easy to change if you choose to do it differently. Now we're gonna go to power on. If you'd like to change it and personalize it a little bit, you can add a custom boot image, or in this case, we can change the text. Here we go, we'll add our name and call sign there. How cool is that? Now let's go to display, right here, the standby BK picture. We'll just change that to custom one. I'll show you what we're doing there in a second. Click OK. And now let's go up to tool, and then go to standby BK picture one. This is actually the background image. So instead of having just a plain black background that your radio comes with, we can spice it up a little bit. So click on open image. And from there, go find your CPS when you installed it. And you'll want to go to screens right here. Once you're there, there's all kinds of different cool backgrounds you can pick from. So if we pick a background here, let's find one. There you go. How about this one? That looks good. Just open that. There you go. And write to radio. Just click the right button. Click OK. And it's going to write that to the radio. Now it's not going to show up straight away. Here we go, complete. We will actually have to write over the new code plug that tells it to use that image, and then we're going to be set. So you can X out of here and just wait for that radio to show back up in the COM port settings. There you go, it showed back up. Now at this point, go ahead and click on the write to radio button. Click OK. Make sure, since we did choose the digital contact list, you want to go ahead and check that box and then click OK. Now, just as a side note, that will take a little while depending on your radio and computer. That may take 10 minutes or so. So just keep that in mind. Today, we're going to not check this just to save some time. But assuming you have that time and you want your digital contact list, go ahead and check that. There you go, write data complete. And we can go ahead and unplug the radio here in a second. There you go, unplug your radio. There we go, how cool is that? So this is just the ordinary zone that we never got rid of. So we can switch over to our zone. And there we go, there's our local, there's the parrot and the Missouri worldwide and disconnect that we installed in the radio. So how cool is that? We programmed our radio. We have a cool background image now. Testing 1, 2, 3, W3AMG.
W3AMG.
And we are up and running.